We want to welcome you to Countdown to Courage, an outreach ministry of the Calvary Baptist Church of Union Grove. Happy Friday. It's July the 30th, 2021. I hope you're having a great day today, and we're excited to be able to come to you just for a few moments today. We've come with hopefully some verses and some words that are going to be an encouragement and refreshing in your heart and life today. And so I hope you'll hang in there with us for the next few moments. If you're able to, I believe we're going to give you some good content today. And I believe that you'll go away encouraged. And so we welcome you. It looks like we've got a good crowd that's tuning in. And so we thank the Lord and we praise the Lord for that. Let me go ahead and encourage you, if you will, to grab your Bibles. We're going to show you several verses today. We'll put the references up on the screen. If you're driving, or if you're not in a situation where you can look at these physically right now, then you can go back later and watch the broadcast, and you can get these references off the screen, and you can go back and study them out for yourselves. We're going to give you some fantastic scriptures today. It's going to be such a blessing in your heart and life. But we're going to go ahead and do this. We're going to say some howdies real quickly, and then we're going to get right into the broadcast, and we're not going to keep you very long at all today. So again, I hope you'll just hang in there just for a few moments, and we hope that we are able to be a blessing. And so anyway, let's go ahead. And by the way, be sure, if you will, to like and share the broadcast. And be sure you comment, because if you don't comment, we may not be able to know that you're aboard. And we'd love to recognize you on the air if possible. Almeda Campbell's watching today. Almeda, good to see you. Hope you and Charles are having a good day today. Charles is on here as well. And hey, we appreciate you folks. Look forward to seeing you tonight. Amen. And I appreciate your text earlier today. The Hooks are watching today. Barry, it was good to see you last night. And I think you guys are planning on being there tonight. Looking forward to seeing you all the way from Morganton, North Carolina. That's wonderful. We're going to have a great time tonight. And yes, we did have a blast last night. It was so much fun. We came home last night and watched the videos over and over again and just laughed, and it was a blessing. Let's see here. My little sis is watching today. Carrie Lippert is watching today. She must be taking a break or something. And so anyway, good to see my sister Carrie watching today. Let me see here. Harrison Wabairu. Harrison, good to see you watching from the country of Kenya today. And look forward to meeting you guys one of these days soon. And so, Harrison, thanks for what you're doing there in your corner of the world for the Lord. Keep it up. Doing a great job. Keep it up. We enjoy seeing the videos and the pictures on Facebook. And so thanks for making a difference for the cause of Christ, my friend. Good to see you today. The Divinis are watching today. Amen. We welcome the Divinis. Miss Barbara, good to see you back on here. And whoever else it may be watching with you today, good to see you, Miss Barbara. God bless you. Rodney Tomlin, Brother Rodney, good to see you today. Brother Rodney says, good afternoon, Calvary family. So ready to meet for VBS tonight and finish with with a bang. Amen, Brother Rodney. It's going to be off the charts tonight, and looking forward to a great, great time. The Gillies are on here with us. We welcome Donnie and Tamara. Good to see you guys. Looking forward to seeing you in just a little bit. Karen Hoffman is aboard. Karen, good to see you. Hope you're having a wonderful Friday. Look forward to seeing you in just a little while. Sherry Pendergrass, Michael and Sherry Pendergrass are watching today. And we welcome Michael and Sherry aboard. Countdown family, help me welcome them. Patsy Byrd is watching. Patsy, good to see you. Hope you're having a great day there in Harmony. Joyce Jones is watching today. She says, thank you for the great week at Bible school. Amen, Joyce. We've had a great week. It's really been supernatural. God's poured out his blessings this week. It's been a happy place, folks. I'm going to tell you what it really has. And Joyce, good to see you aboard today. God bless you. Michelle Hoots is watching. She says, watching with Stephanie. Amen. Well, Michelle and Stephanie, good to see y'all. Thanks for tuning in. Thanks for all the hard work this week. Appreciate you guys in a big way. Mike Hill is here. Brother Mike and Miss Nina did a fantastic job with our adult class. Man, what a blessing. 57 last night in the adult class. Man, what do you say about that except praise the Lord? I mean, to God be the glory. And man, great week with our adults. We thank the Lord for that. Let's see. Okay, my sis said, actually, Gracie's watching. And so, Gracie, good to see you today. That's my niece. And so, Gracie, we welcome you. Missed you at Bible school this week. Man, I wish you guys could have made it. And hey, if you can make it tonight, come on tonight. We're going to have a great time. That'll be great. Abel Seitz is on here with us today. Abel got his wife picked last night for Mr. Noah Built an Ark. We did not know. We did not know that Miss Lauren was so talented in doing animal impersonations last night. And so anyway, you had to be there to understand that if you didn't watch and I guess you didn't watch it because we didn't broadcast it live, but there are some videos floating around on Facebook. And so anyway, Abel, good to see you today. Drusilla and Martin are watching today. We welcome the Mendozas aboard. Good to see you guys today. Let me see here. Make sure I don't miss anybody. Well, listen, that's most of the ones that I can see. There may be some others that you can see that I can't. We've got a great crowd on here today, maybe our best crowd all week. And so we thank the Lord for that. And that is a blessing. Let me take you to the split screen. And we are rejoicing over last night. What a night. What a night last night. And we had so much fun. I had adults who don't attend Calvary Baptist Church. I had adults coming up to me after the service last night saying, man, we had a blast tonight. We had so much fun. And so anyway, we're just thankful. My wife and I were having this conversation a while ago. Our vacation Bible school is not, you know, it's not your typical VBS. It's sort of VBS slash youth conference slash revival. It's it has been honestly there is no explanation for this week outside of supernatural, just the blessings of God. That's what it is. And so to God be the glory, great things He hath done, and we're thankful. We had just great crowds every night. We ended last night with 334 in attendance, 57 in the adult class. We had 11 professions of faith. We had quite a few more hands raised this week for salvation. But those were the folks that actually came to me at the close of the service and acknowledged that they had made a decision. And so anyway, great week and a fun week. And it really was the happiest place on earth this week. And I'm going to tell you, just to look out there and to see those little faces smiling and to see some kids get prizes. And it has been, wow, it's been a little piece of heaven on this side of heaven this week. And if you were there, you know what I'm talking about. If you missed it, you missed it. I hate it. And but anyway, listen, tonight we're going to do it. We're going to do one last shebang tonight, all right? And so 7 o'clock, we're going to kick everything off. Everything's going to be on the property tonight. We're not going to be in the auditorium, Lord willing. And so we'll have all the inflatables for the children. We'll have food and drink. We have the coffee truck that's going to be there tonight. The ice cream truck's going to be there tonight. We have got the dunk tank that's going to be going. We've got hay rides going. We have got the bubble ball that's going tonight. If you saw the video last night, you know what I'm talking about. That's going to be incredible. And that's for the adults and the teenagers. And then we will end the night off with a huge fireworks presentation. And so it's just going to be a great night. Bring your folding chairs, your camping chairs, whatever you call those, and so you can sit them out around the property later tonight. But 7 o'clock, hope you'll be there. Come excited, and we're looking forward to what the Lord is going to do. Well, listen, that's enough of that. Let's get right into the broadcast today, and we'll just give you a few quick thoughts. And so today we're talking about this, some things that can give you confidence in prayer. Yesterday on the broadcast, we were talking about one of the things that hinders prayer, and that's a limited faith. When we don't pray with confidence, God wants us to come to Him with a heart of confidence, trusting Him. And so I want to do this today and maybe next week for a little while. I want to give you some things that might be confidence boosters when it comes to your prayer life. What are some things that will help you concerning your confidence in your prayer life. And we'll just give you one thought today. How about this? Number one is this, that we have a God that hears. Now, that's a simple little thought, but we have a God that hears. And how incredibly important it is for us to point this out. And I'm going to give you some great, great scriptures today. Let's start with this one. How about 1 John 5:14? The Bible says, and this is the confidence. Well, that's what we're talking about. And this is the confidence that we have in Him, that if we ask anything according to His will, He, talking about God, He heareth us. And so our Bible is very clear to point out here that we have a God that that hears our prayers. And by the way, if you read that next verse, we won't do it today, but if you read that next verse, the Bible says He not only hears our prayers, but He answers our prayers. God, our Heavenly Father, who loved you so much that He gave His only Son for you, desires to give you the desires of your heart. And so anyway, we're so thankful that God hears us. How about 1 Peter chapter 3 and verse number 12? The Bible says, for the eyes of the Lord are over the righteous, and His ears are open unto their prayers. But the face of the Lord is against them that do evil. And so our Bible says that His ears are open. His ears are open unto our prayers. How about Exodus chapter 3 and verse number 7? And the Lord said, I have surely seen the affliction of my people which are in Egypt, and have heard their cry by reason of their taskmasters, for I know their sorrows. And man, we got blessed. I think it was on Sunday night we were talking about that we have a high priest that has been touched with the feeling of our infirmities. No, we were talking about it Sunday school. That's right, Sunday school on Sunday morning. And that the Lord Jesus Christ knows your burdens. He knows your pains. He knows the valleys and the storms that you've been through. And He's touched with the feeling of our infirmities. And the Bible says right there that He knows our sorrows. Get this verse, because this is absolutely incredible. How about Isaiah 49, verses 14 through 16? Listen to what our scripture says here. But Zion said, the Lord hath forsaken me, and my Lord hath forgotten me. And listen to what the Lord says. Can a woman forget her sucking child, that she should not have compassion on the son of her womb? In other words, can a woman that has a newborn baby forget that baby? Well, there's nothing natural about that. And that's what He's saying there. But look at what He says. Yea, they may forget. Doesn't happen very often, but it's possible. Yea, they may forget. And then God says this, yet will I not forget thee. Behold, I have graven thee upon the palms of my hands. Thy walls are continually before me. Now, again, the point I'm trying to make today is this, that God hears. God is very aware of your situation. He's aware of your problems. He's interested. He's interested in your problems. He's not just interested in the problems of the world. No. He's a personal Lord and Savior. And He's interested in your personal issues. He's interested in your fears. He's interested in your valley that you're going through right now. He's interested in your storm that you're facing right now. And we have a God that hears us. Listen, have you ever done this? Have you ever been talking to someone on a cell phone and you got in a bad area and they were talking and they started cutting out? Or maybe you started cutting out and they said, I can't hear you. And you were talking and you were trying to say your words precisely, but they couldn't hear you. And so then you tried to start talking loud and they couldn't hear you. And they said, can you hear me? Can you hear me? I can't hear you. Remember how aggravating that was? Or maybe you were carrying on a conversation with someone on your cell phone only to realize that the call got dropped. Maybe even, 30 seconds ago, 60 seconds ago, and you'd just been going on and on and on, and the call got dropped a long time ago. You remember how aggravating that is? And sometimes it can be quite aggravating. You have you ever done this? Have you ever been talking to someone that was very hard of hearing, and bless their heart, they just couldn't hear. And you had a hard time communicating with them because they could not hear you. Have you ever done this? Boy, I bet a lot of you can relate to this. Have you ever called some kind of a company or a business, and it made you go through one of these automated systems, and it would say one for this or say two for this, and you would say something, and they would come back. The automation would come back and say, "We didn't understand your answer. Could you speak it again?" And they couldn't understand what you were trying to say. And remember how aggravating that was, because they couldn't seem to hear you. Have you ever done this? Have you ever went through a drive-thru at a restaurant, and as you were trying to place your order, there was a lack of communication? They just couldn't hear you, or you couldn't hear them. Now, you say, "Pastor, why are you even saying all that?" I said all that to say this. Aren't you glad that we never have to go through an automated system to get through to our Heavenly Father? Boy, did you know that we have a direct line to heaven? Jeremiah 33:3, God said, "Call unto me, and I will answer thee and show thee great and mighty things which thou knowest not." Man, I'm so glad that when I call God, I never get a busy signal. I'm so glad that when I call my Heavenly Father, the call is never dropped. I'm so glad that when I call God, I never have to say, "Lord, I can't hear you," or "He can't hear me." Oh, listen, I'm so glad. And by the way, and I'll end it right there today, but I just want to tell you that what a blessing it is. And that ought to give us confidence as we go into the presence of our Heavenly Father. We understand something. He's hearing us. He's hearing us. He's listening to us. And when you've got a heavy heart and you think that nobody cares, well, I'm so glad to tell you that you can go to Him and He cares for you. And He hears you when you call out to Him. Well, what a blessing. Hallelujah. Man, that's a simple word, but it's a good word today. Hey, listen, I want to do this if I could. I want to put some numbers on your screen. It's our prayer helpline number, 704-327-5662. If you're watching this broadcast today and you do not know the Lord Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, you don't know that you're on your way to heaven, would you call us? We would love to talk to you about that a little bit. We'd love to share Christ with you and tell you how you can know that you know that you know that you're going to spend eternity in heaven. You say, "Brother Pope, can you know?" You better believe you can. And so would you call us, 704-327-5662. I promise you, we won't ask you for a handout or a gift or money or anything like that. Oh, no. Myself or one of our prayer helpline workers would like to call you back, and we'd like to give you some scripture on how you can know Christ as personal Savior. If you're watching this broadcast today and you've got a heavy, heavy burden, maybe the valley that you're walking through today is a very deep one, why don't you call us? And we would love to call you and pray with you and walk through that valley with you today. And so 704-327-5662. If you can't get through on that number, call the other one, 704-539-5340. Hey, Countdown family, don't forget, be kind to everyone, because everyone's having a tough time. Let's be kind to everybody. Calvary family and anyone else who wants to come, we'll look forward to seeing you tonight on the property at 7 p.m. It's going to be a great Friday night finale as we end off our VBS week. And so listen, until then, have a great day and God bless you.